We now discuss the direction cosines of a line, or more precisely the direction cosines of a directed line. Suppose we have a directed line in the space, in the three-dimensional space with the three axes, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. So consider this, the three axes, x-axis, y-axis, z-axis, or ox, the positive direction of the x-axis, oy, the positive direction of the y-axis, and oz, the positive direction of the z-axis. And now suppose there is a line in this space with this axis. Suppose this line, the directed line, makes angles alpha, beta, gamma with the positive direction of the x, y and z axis. Then cosine of these angles, that is cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma, are called the direction cosines of this line. Any line in space making angles alpha, beta, gamma with the positive directions of the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, then cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are the direction cosines of this line. And now, if the line is directed in the opposite direction, then the angles will be pi minus alpha, pi minus beta, pi minus gamma, and in this case the direction cosines will be cos alpha, cos beta, cos pi minus alpha, cos pi minus beta and cos pi minus gamma. These values are numerically same as this cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma, but with opposite signs. We can see that. But we always choose the direction cosines as a set of three values in a unique way. For this, we always take this alpha, beta, gamma, the angles made by the line with the positive directions of the axis, and this cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma as the direction cosines. And now, again we can see that there is a close relationship between these direction cosines. Usually these direction cosines are denoted by L, M and N. L equal to cos alpha, M equal to cos beta and N equal to cos gamma. So to find the relation between these L, M and N, we mark these angles in the coordinate space. For this, to mark it conveniently, we draw a line parallel to the given line passing through the origin. Then since these two lines being parallel, the second line makes the very same angles alpha, beta, gamma with these axes, same angles. That is, this angle is alpha, this angle is beta and this angle is gamma. And now, suppose P, X, Y, Z be any point on the line. P, X, Y, Z any point on the line. Draw PL perpendicular to x-axis. PL perpendicular to x-axis. And then, this is a right angle triangle. OPL is a right angled triangle. From that right angle triangle, we see that this cos alpha is equal to this adjacent side OL divided by hypotenuse OP. That is, this L is equal to this OL is the x coordinate of the point P, which is x, and OP is the distance between these two points, origin and P, and let us take this distance as say small r for convenience. So we see that this L is equal to x by r. Similarly, drawing perpendiculars to y axis and z axis, we can see that m is equal to y by r and n is equal to z by r. Or of course multiplying x equal to lr, y equal to mr, z is equal to nr. Suppose we square and add these three equations, squaring and adding, we get left side equal to x squared plus y squared plus z squared equal to right side, which is l squared r squared plus m squared r squared plus n squared r squared, which is equal to r squared is common to all these three terms. So taking outside, r squared into l squared plus m squared plus n squared. And now consider this r squared. R squared is this OP squared, which is the square of the distance between these two points O and P. O is the origin with the coordinates 0, 0, 0. And therefore, this OP squared is equal to x minus 0 whole squared plus y minus 0 whole squared plus z minus 0 whole squared. Or this r squared is x squared plus y squared plus z squared. That is, here we see that this r squared equal to r squared into l squared plus m squared plus n squared. Hence, cancelling this r squared from both sides, we see that l squared plus m squared plus n squared is equal to 1. The sum of the squares of the direction cosines is always 1. Sum of the squares of the direction cosines is always equal to 1. So this is the relation connecting this direction cosine. This is an important result which we frequently use in problems. And again, if we have a line passing through two given points with the coordinates say x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2, then we can find the direction cosines in terms of the coordinates of these two points, x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2, which is also important we make use of in problems. So let us see what is the direction cosines in that situation. So consider the three axes, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, and the line. Suppose this line passes through two points, the two points P, x1, y1, z1, and the q is x2, y2, and z2. x2, y2, and z2. Here also we draw this perpendicular PL, QM perpendicular to x axis, and PN perpendicular to this QM. Then this is a right angled triangle. And this angle is alpha, which is the angle made by the line with the positive direction of the x-axis. This PN is parallel to this x-axis and therefore this angle is alpha clearly. And from that right angle triangle, this cos alpha is equal to, adjacent side PN divided by PQ. And now consider this PN. PN is same as this LM. And LM is equal to OM minus OL. OM is x coordinate of this Q, which is x2. And OL is x coordinate of this point P, which is x1. So this LM, that is PN, is x2 minus x1. And therefore, this L is equal to this x2 minus x1 divided by. Similarly, drawing all these with the y and z axis, we see that m is equal to y2 minus y1 by pq and n is equal to z2 minus z1 by pq. Thus, in this case, the direction cosines are this x2 minus x1 by pq, y2 minus y1 by pq, and z2 minus z1 by pq. And now consider this pq. Pq is the distance between this p and q. And p is the point x1 by 1 z1 and q is the point x2 by 2 z2. And therefore again here using the distance formula, we see that this pq is equal to square root of this x2 minus x1 whole squared plus y2 minus y1 whole squared plus z2 minus z1 whole squared. Thus, the direction cosines of the line passing through x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2 is this x2 minus x1 by pq, pq is this, y2 minus y1 by pq, z2 minus z1 by pq. Okay, that's all.